as a born again believer, the pathway to intercourse and family building is marriage. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
And that's what you subscribe to.
Yep.
And there is no negotiating with you.
Oh no! What am I negotiating about? I get to negotiate a lot.
So there are aspects of my life that I will never reveal. That are between myself, my family.
And we became and who God. We are because of that past and that history. Mm. We became strong women because we know who we are.
Abafundisi and all of that, I mean, I heard the audible voice of God.
It wasn't the decision.
On the third day.
Oh, that one, yeah.
Like Christ himself.
What was that about?
I don't even know.
So you can't just trust the person who was able to initiate a relationship with your husband knowingly and trust them with your life, with your kid.
A fancy restaurant in a beautiful place in South Africa. And he left you with 7,000.
Love them. Boots, babe. He's not circumcised.
I meant our sex.
Our sex.
I mean, okay. I already do like that.
Yes.
Will it marry what you say you're doing? Which is...
kuthiwa ngesiZulu umuhle izintokaza nentokazi emhlophe ngathi sihlabathi solwandle. Yes, did I get that right? The show is Engineer Your Life and I'm Lungelo KM. Welcome to another episode. Of course, if you clicked this, it means you've seen the thumbnail and you know who I'm sitting with today. She's an actress. She's also a musician. I recently found out that she's also into makeup, not just any makeup, but a very intensive, detailed level of makeup that not many people can go into. Angel, how are you, my darling?
Oh, good. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you for finally coming.
Yay! It's been a long time coming.
No, but you're working so hard and that's good.
Yeah, it's been really hectic. Yeah. It was even July, so it was pretty.
And man, celebrity status, but it's...
Hi guys. It's getting there.
Yeah.
It's getting there.
Let's just get this out of the way. So ukhuleka nokushaya nini njobe usunje?
How? Wangiphusha emadepsini.
Wangiphusha exactly. Bese ningabona to yena.
You know, man. No, it was like that.
Yeah.
No, I slept on sets. I was literally walking down the stairs.
Yeah.
Everybody knows.
Yeah.
I slept on one of those long stairs.
Yeah.
But okay, I'm getting there. I'm almost. Yeah, I'm almost there.
Yeah. Are you enjoying the role? It seems to be... Of course, it has come with complete changes in your life, but are you enjoying it?
I am enjoying it. It's definitely different from the first one.
Sure.
If you remember, Umkhokha, it was a telenovela.
Yes.
It was a series, sorry.
Yes, a drama series.
It was a drama series, 13 episodes.
So it was quick.
It was nice and quick, yeah, but so a lot of information about the character.
Sure.
Whereas now, everything now is...
Detailed.
And now it's nice and longer and everything. Jay, stories are going to progress slowly.
Yeah, yeah.
So now, I'm really enjoying it. I'm loving the things that are coming, Jay, from the character now. I'm just like, wow, okay. It has improved a lot.
Something that has been in the media recently about you, which I found very interesting. Why is everybody so concerned about how old you are?
No, what? People are concerned.
They are so concerned. Like,
no.
Promise you. You missed that?
Yeah.
I promise you. Kunale debate of Uguti. That roles that you are playing are not in line with your age. And I'm like, but that's what acting is.
Wait, what are you...
What are you talking about? Promise you.
Yeah. I didn't know there was like a debate or whatever.
Yeah.
I am portraying Ishama Rosa. I'm the oldest, older than me.
Definitely.
Like
definitely.
4 or 5 years older than me.
Definitely. Yeah.
Wow. I didn't know that.
It's interesting though, because it means you're portraying it well if people are not able to see the difference.
Well, yes, yeah. That's the whole idea.
That's the whole idea
of
acting.
You need to sell the character as it is, not yourself.
Are you enjoying being a married woman on set?
I hate it so much. I hate it because I never got to enjoy the whole thing of being engaged and having the wedding. Like, God, what's our social deal? No, man, I broke as well.
So figures like pele.
I know, we missed some few steps there. How?
Yeah.
So, I don't like it.
Yeah. And since we're there, do you believe in marriage in your personal life?
Yes, definitely. Yeah. I am a born again Christian. Mm-hmm. So if you want to, you know, you have to get married first and. So I do believe in marriage. I believe it's a beautiful thing. Yeah, they always get in marriage. And
so as a born again believer, the pathway to intercourse and family building is marriage. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
And that's what you subscribe to?
Yep.
And there is no negotiating with you?
Oh, no. What am I negotiating about? I get things to negotiate a lot. Even with black people back then, guys, they don't really as much as they did back then. But it was a big issue. When you saw whatever the case is, that's a bad thing for everyone. Everybody can agree on that. Whether you're a Christian or you're not a Christian or whatever you believe in, you can agree with me on this one. But yeah, people do what people want to do. I'm not a judge.
Living true to your name, I guess.
There's different types of angels, but hey, I don't know. Maybe, yeah.
Perhaps let's explore that idea just a little bit. I don't want to dwell on it because today is about you. Is perhaps one of the issues that we're suffering from a lot of people are depressed in relationships. A lot of people, relationships are ending. Many relationships perhaps don't have the unkulunkulu and the unity in them.
Yeah.
It's because people haven't committed to finding partners in a manner that we wait, we find each other spiritually, emotionally, we connect, and then finally we can partake in sexual intercourse and things like that.
I think a lot of young people are suffering from syndrome yokuba lonely. They're feeling lonely.
Yeah.
And instead of trying to figure out izinto umuntu angazenza to keep themselves busy. Because umuntu busy occupied with themselves and whatever it is, they ask as I'm getting or iskole, they don't really get the chance to I feel lonely. You're too busy.
Yeah,
like a lot is going on.
Yeah.
So so we have people who have so much time in their hands that they feel lonely most of the time. And ekubeni lonely wabo, they end up doing izinto prematurely because they feel lonely and they want to be loved. I understand, we all want to be loved. Everybody wants to be loved and in a relationship, whatever the case is. But ungalenzi iphutha lokungena kwi relationship just because you want to be loved, ungene prematurely when you're not ready, when you have a lot of things that you need to work on yourself first, you know, even loving yourself first more. There's a lot to try and, but obviously ngeke ulinde forever. Khona into ozongena na relationship owazi ukuthi okay le na le iyangihlula. But at least ungena aware ukuthi okay 1 or 2 or 3 usangihlula and ngiyazama. Nokuthi uzo discover yonke into wena ngawe nje in relationship.
Rorisang Tandegiso, I don't know if you know her. She's a big TV personality. She was on SABC 1. She's also a musician.
I know.
She recently went on a podcast and she revealed that part of her virtues as a pure woman, and I'll use the word pure because that's how she described it. But when she says pure, she means she's never engaged in intercourse. She's in her 30s now. And she says one of the issues that she always comes across is that when she meets a guy, maybe a guy who's umshele, will say, okay, I agree, we will wait till marriage. But 3 months down the line, 6 months down the line, okay, guy loses interest because We are ifuna lento, but ubesabekezela, ubesabekezela.
Yeah, hoping
do you come across that with relationships you try?
Inkingama, I don't even try relationships.
Hi, I'm sus.
I don't even know. So here's the thing. Here's how I was raised and here's what God said to me.
Sure.
Because we can serve the same God, but see, Asho isn't doing a funny thing.
Sure.
Because now it's a band of fun. We are designed in a very in different ways. Yeah, but corner in day weakness, it's like how?
Yes.
So, mina, how I was raised at church was if when the husband comes, or your wife comes, God is going to be the one to show you, okay,
who it is.
This is your wife and all of that. And then you act on that. Obviously, you don't want to waste this kasomundi when you already know that this person is meant to be with me. Why waste time? Because you already know. But obviously, as people, we want to know each other first and all of that. We get a few things out of the way. But gay research is you need 3 months to know a person.
Yeah, minimum.
Only three. No, only three. Yes.
So after 3 months, it's ngashatayikhale.
After 3 months, it's ngakhale. And you know after 3 months, the relationship was doomed from beginning. You'll know after 3 months.
And a lot of people will know, but they're in denial.
Yes. They'll hold on and have hope. In like 3 months is all you need to know. Is it going to work or not? You just need to take and just use your mind for once. But as I was saying, going back to this thing, as a Christian, God knows everything about you. God created you. He knows abazali bakho babeka ngendlela umele uze kulomndeni lo okhulela khulele khona udlule into nodlula kuzona. So I believe ukuthi even when it comes to relationships, friends I have ingoba babeka uNkulunkulu empilweni yami. Anginawo umngani mina nje owavelwa bomngani nje esikhaleni. Akekho umngani okhona okwenzile ukuthi empilweni yami khona into afika nayo, khona i-lesson azofika nayo, be it good or bad or painful or joyful or whatever the case is. Kanjalo ne-relationship, like romantic relationships, God knows everything about you. He designed your whole life. He had it all planned out. So he knows it's okay. When an angel, I've designed this lovely gentleman. I hope he's handsome. I've designed this gentleman for you. So the reason why I'm not even interested in like wasting
it's
other
because of that conviction.
It's because of that. God was like, don't even bother in wasting your time in dating. You're not gonna find your husband there.
So you're saying the Holy Spirit will guide you towards a husband?
The Holy Spirit told me not to date because I won't find my husband there. The whole reason for people to date in datela in. So that you can get, as a Christian, I believe, you know. So if you're dating for fun, whose heart are you having fun with?
Power.
Do you get what I'm saying? Like, you can't say you're having fun with other people's hearts. That's not right. If you're dating, you should be dating because we are zufuna and you want to settle down, you want to get married. So what I'm saying is, nami mhla efika umyeni, only God can confirm ukuthi lo muntu lo obizongilandela njengamanje is actually the one. Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's how I know me now as an angel. This is the one. But he told me very clearly, you're not going to find him in dating and going out and all of that. That's why I don't even waste time. They try, but I'm like, no.
But I mean, as you're saying that the Holy Spirit told you not to date, what if the day the Holy Spirit does bring you the husband and you feel that signal, oh, this is the person, you just don't love them?
I don't think that will ever be the case.
Okay.
I don't think that will ever be the case. One thing I'll tell you so far about my life is that I thought was good for me. And I thought, okay, this career is definitely the one. I can draw. My father works in construction. What I had reasons that made sense. And I went and did architecture. I hated it.
Sure, I hear you.
God said way before I did architecture, but I went to act. That's it.
That's not a real job.
You know, I felt like that.
Yeah.
Until ngangena architecture, and then God made sure ukuthi ufaka umuntu ka architecture ozongifaka la ka acting. Ubaba kwa esebenza kuzala at that time.
Yeah.
And I'd always talk to her about, oh, I love uzala so much. I want to act in uzala. The girl kept quiet for a good 6 months.
Wow.
She kept quiet and said nothing. And then she tells me one day, she's like, you know, Angel, my father actually works Kaguzal. I'm like, what? The next day, I was an extra. I fell in love with that job. And what I'm saying is, God knew or was it, this is what I've called you for. And I want you to stand. This is where your heart is going to be. So yes, he definitely cannot bring me a person that I'm not going to love. I can guarantee on that one. There's no way. Mm. Oh God, table. No ways. But yeah, I don't think that will ever be the case. Sometimes in devil and then when you start doing them, and then you realize, shucks, this thing I'm actually called for and I'm good at it without even trying so hard.
You sound very convicted with God designing your life in a certain way and you just having to stay in path for it to unfold in that way and for you to live God's purpose for your life.
Yeah.
What if God's purpose is for you to get married at 42? Are you still willing to wait till then?
Yeah. Mm. Guys, I ain't gonna give away the prize for nothing. No ways. I'm not gonna settle for less, unfortunately. It has to be standard sankulunkulu because it says your ways, his ways are higher than our ways. Thoughts, it's like yabona umehluko between umhlaba nesibhakabhaka. That's how high unkulunkulu asicabanga ngakhona. So even if it's 42, uyaze ukuthi uplanel ngalowa 42, shuthi ngizobe ngisamuhle. 42 low. Well,
I want to go into the work a bit. So as you're saying, you were studying architecture. Did you eventually complete or did you just go straight into acting?
No.
So the calling was too strong that you were like...
I didn't quit. So I didn't drop out. It wasn't me who decided, okay, nyaye, I'm not that person, Stella Sam. If I start something now, there's no way I'm going to drop. I will partner now. I did architecture. Nyawokala ngaba nemlenze, I think it was 2. Came back the following year, ngilungisa lo mlenze leyo. Came back the following year, ngiyakwesithathu sengenza second year manje. Ikwenzeni kwami lo second year lowo ke. Hayi, kuba khona omunye futhi umlenze. Ngoba ayi ngangayifuni architecture. I'm telling you, I hated it so much. But ngangiphasa futhi kodwa ngayifuni. Then I came back for lemlenze u 2.
Guys, imlenze is failed modules.
Failed
it's not
modules.
Legs.
Y'all also know what that is. But anyways, I came back for second year. As I was doing in second year around June, and then I had umlenze odwa, I think. Yeah, I had one module that was...
dribbling.
That module was not the one. Anybody who's done architecture, they can tell you, ukuthi la module leya is not the one. Shame. Yo, I had messed with me so much. Ngalendlela ukuthi they called it dean, the whole dean, a faculty yonke azonhlayisa phansi. But we're gonna have to take you out of the program. Ngathi how? Kubani? And then they're like, your group or lo nyaka wafika ngawo. You guys were the last people that benzi diploma ka architect. So the people that come after you benzi degree, ama modules wabo nawe nawa fan. So if you have lomlenze lo, ungesikwazi ukuqhubeka nge second semester ephansi next year, shoot and we must hire one person to teach you that.
Hectic.
Module. And I'm like,
not the system kicking you out.
They kicked me out. I was like, thank you. I walked out. I was like, yes! Because I needed a way out. My parent was paying. When as far as it was not funding anything, and I applied and they kept on being like being gap in as far as. But yeah, it's fine. So
I'm famous now.
Yes, and as far as what you gotta say? Thank you. But anyways, yeah, they kept on denying me funding. And then eventually bank kicked out at DUT when I was doing architecture leo. I was doing for a whole year. Like I was doing my gigs of music and makeup, and then bam, my first big break came for 2020 during lockdown.
I want you to us to not leave that point of and just depart from the fact that you felt that it was a big break moment. But I want you to take me just before that big break when you had lost school, you kicked out of the program in architecture. And now you're just trying a few things. What are these things that you are trying? And what lessons did you learn when you were trying? Because I'd say you were hustling. What lessons did you learn there?
I discovered something about myself I don't think I knew because I wasn't put in a position of hustling just to make ends meet.
Sure.
You know? At that time, I don't think anyone had a job at Kaya. Or a proper job. Everyone is just piss jobs and all of that. So ngafunda lapha ukuthi yazini awukwazi ukulamba unezandla. I didn't have a qualification.
Sure.
But I had hands that can draw.
Yeah.
I need to draw somebody's face. Mm. Then that's how I started makeup. Good time, man. I need to take this seriously, you know. And then I started investing in myself. I did a lot of my tapes teaching how to do it. I'm tutorials and all of that. And then I was like, I sing, man. Let me do some videos. I mean, Ula, some Disney songs and whatever. And I started doing a lot of that. And obviously, gigs kept coming. My gigs of music. My gigs of makeup. So that's what I was ngangiphilanga lokho nje at that time. It was makeup, it was music, makeup and music. And along the pelis on Donga Yanga somewhere.
Sure.
Or at least two places. So yeah. it was quite busy. I'm a fan con.
And who gave you your like one of your biggest music gigs? Or who gave you actually your first music gig?
Okay. I don't know if you remember Spelelengcobo from Idols.
Yes,
I think 2016, I don't know, Susan Ba. But yes. Yes, that's one. That's my brother, that's one.
Yeah.
So Uspe wearing my crown got some music awards. Me and Safun discovered I was in grade 10. I was like, please, come find my crown. He's like, what grade are you doing? I'm like, grade 10. He's like, oh, child, at least go to grade 12 and then we can talk. The moment I finished grade 12, I'm like, November. He's like, next year, my darling, because obviously I'm a crown on November now, so you guys won't get a match. So that was my first gig, music, and it was on Crown Gospel Music Awards, the biggest ever.
Yeah.
From there, kept going.
So you were a backing vocalist there?
Yes, I still am.
Really?
A backing vocalist. You know this thing of being a backing vocalist, guys? It's a pretty serious job.
And it's sustainable.
It's very sustainable.
Because I'm an artist, I'm a lead artist.
Yes.
Ne? But mubeka ungabekela number.
Ungabekela number ni forever and ever. It just keeps coming. You just keep doing your job.
Yeah. And no aspirations to be a lead vocalist?
Well, eventually. I mean, people are putting so much pressure on me.
Really?
And I'm like, guys, why are you needing for any pressure? People are always like, Angel, keep her in.
Your heart is not in it yet.
Not yet.
Yeah. And that's okay.
Yeah. I mean, as a Christian, I can just send them. And that's it. You just did it. And okay, fine. That's all. No. Whatever it is, wherever God has placed you, kona impact ozoba nayo. Whether kubantu ngokuphila nje namuka nje, or your ministry, officially in my case, solo music run. So mina, my biggest fear is starting ngithi ngiyaqala music kwami uvele ungathinti imuntu.
I hear you. From Joyous Celebration, there was a 4 to 5 year break where Superstar, who is now a superstar but actually doesn't take herself like a superstar because I think she's so centered in God, Claire, did not release anything.
Yeah,
a lot of people were putting pressure on her, release a single, release an album, release a single, release an album. And I remember I bumped into her, I was with a friend who knew her, and she said, God hasn't given me the right album yet. You know?
Yeah.
It's not that I'm not working.
Yeah.
I'm working.
Yeah.
But the Holy Spirit hasn't given me that right album yet.
Yeah.
And where is she now? When she gave us that right album.
Exactly.
That first album, Your Kingdom on Earth, every single track in that album is absolutely amazing.
Exactly my point.
Today, she's signed to an American record label and she's going to sing at the Stellars.
Yo.
Because she listened to the voice of the Holy Spirit as you sing. So I can absolutely relate to what you're saying.
Yeah, I think God's timing is perfect.
Yeah.
So I can't listen to God's timing with his and then other things and be like, nah, no.
Yeah.
I have to listen to his timing. Yeah.
So what is the big break then, now that we've built up to that point? What was that big break where you felt like, okay, this is the big break that I've got to step foot into the industry?
Okay, when acting, it was Uzalo, 2020. It was days before my birthday. I believe it was a birthday gift.
It is.
I always say, God, you gave me such a beautiful gift. But I want to act. But kissing scenes, and I'm like, Father, how are we going to balance that? Because I don't know if I can do that.
Yeah.
You smart. And then God was like, no, wait for COVID, my darling. Then, exactly. And then I got the role on Uzalo as Uzetsu. Uzetsu was in Tomazan Sotsontini, obviously.
Were you auditioning for that role? Had you been trying to audition a lot for Uzalo? Or how did that come about?
I was an extra from 2017. Long away university. 6 months later, then I started being an extra on Uzalo. For a good 3 years, I think.
Hectic.
Yeah, 2017, 2018, 2019.
So no one knows you because Jay Ulu,
oh no, I made sure everybody knew me.
Really?
But because even my actors are called, I was inside extra. Yeah. Like I knew them, Ganja, school of food in the ambay, and he's extra.
Yes.
Who
would be
extra? I go shuguti.
Uzophelela la.
No, make connections, talk to people, talk, and just know how to, you know, network.
I get that.
You know, so I was an extra for like good 3 years, and then days before my birthday, and Jing, it's that thing, it's hey. I'm like, even the 21st. I'm like, man, the 21st. Manji, lockdown. We're going to versus my dad. No, don't worry, my child. Hank, phone call from Uzal. Hello? Angel, Ish, can you send a video? I'll send you a script. Just do this and send one video singing a song. I'm like, okay. What's going on? Then I sent this video of me singing, and then I sent the video on Gifunda script. My mom was reading Bambat. So everything that was happening on Uzal, my mom knew about. Just putting it out there, all the naughty things she knew, because we were reading the script together.
Yeah.
So that was my first big break on Uzalo. Later that day, they phoned me like, "You got the character. Can you start coming? Shoot? Can you come in next week? The following week and start shooting?" Then I came like.
Now you're shooting at a different scale. Like Safa Nalo got shoot go extra.
No.
All of a sudden we born in main cast ganje in
Luda ganje. Ah no! Then na bola na ngesi ya asi ya ngutu jan yapil. Okay, bofu na 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 ngizai bo bofu na la. Same reason. Yeah, cause I had a few days to, you know, to enjoy.
Yes.
My character was like very small. It was a cameo. So I think some of the stars, they couldn't adjust. They were struggling because I've been an extra for 3 years. But about joy, it was extra.
Sure.
So much. Message room in that lot as prioritized as about two. It's like, and I'm like,
actually, take me there in a production that's that big, that's such a powerhouse. Did you get a lot of being looked down upon when you were still an extra?
Every production.
Yeah.
Most of the production. I think it depends.
Is it from fellow crew? Is it crew members or is it cast that looks down upon you?
Well, they don't necessarily look down upon, but les besebenza kungekho ama extras. They know how they work. They communicate. They've built this arrangement or this life or whatever.
Trust, but working relationship.
Yeah, they know a relationship and how everything works and all of that. And then goes off my extras. Love, we know what miming means. But love, the crew is getting frustrated because they know time. So I don't think it's a thing of looking down. But it's more of when there's not a lot of people around. And then when there's other people, in most cases, how it works behind the scenes and all of that. So it makes life a bit more difficult for them. That's how they get frustrated. And they don't obviously talk to ama extras the same way they'll talk to ama actors. Because with us, wakulumanje, hey, it's a lucky so much. Fast, to spend bad, let's say.
Yeah.
It looks in the back, but if it's an extra, uzokhuluma nobani.
Yeah.
They kind of don't have anyone to talk to at that time.
So, how long did you shoot for that role, Legazetu?
I literally shot 7 days, and then it played for like 3 weeks, I think, on TV.
Yeah, it was.
So
that's
awesome.
Why you didn't get to merge fully with the cast. Because you only shot for 7 days.
7 days. I don't think I created any new relationships per se. It was more of, oh, you're here. And I'm like, yeah. It's like, oh, okay, nice. And then Pelilab. Yeah, but okay.